In that situation, their immediate priority is to move away from that kind of attack and assault and move to an area or a place that is safer. Basically, what they were saying was that this tenancy is not worth my life. I've waited many years for a tenancy, a council tenancy, but it's not worth my life. And even if it means having to squat a flat in a safer area, you know, I am prepared to do that. It is an emergency situation where emergency action has to be taken. And when we talk about moving such families out of their flats, it has to be done literally within 24 hours.
Asians have also found themselves in danger on their way to and from work.
I think this well organized, somebody done it.
The whole situation was very, very well organized. Almost a kind of paramilitary type of organization acted behind this whole attack. They waited until the workers came out of this brewery, and they were systematically attacked very viciously.
Here in Brick Lane, the center of the Bengali community in the East End, attacks on Asians have been common. This Asian shopkeeper, who spent 3 years in a Japanese prisoner of war camp after fighting for Britain in the last war, describes the attack.
It happened, you know, exactly 2 o'clock. Like running down the street, about approximately about 150 or 200 like these youths, you know, all these skinheads, you know. Like swearing, shouting, and throw these stones, break my all windows, and all of a sudden one is coming here. I break my teeth in here. There's the brick. Now we are frightened every Sunday, you know.
Because of these mounting attacks, the policing of Brick Lane has come under criticism from MPs, trade union leaders, as well as many local Asians.
I don't accept that the credibility of the police with the Asian community at large has been dented this year. What in fact has happened is that some of the more vocal Asian leaders have put this point of view forward. The police have had to do a great deal to meet the needs of the Bangladeshi people, to adapt the service that we are giving. When they come to this country, they have many problems. And not only do they have problems, but they set problems for the police which we have to meet. During this year, we have done a whole series of things which has in fact resulted in Brick Lane being the most heavily policed area in Great Britain. Now, much of the criticism directed against police this year is quite unjustified. Sort of the political axe grinding type of criticism that we don't care, that we're not trying. We're professionals, of course we're trying. It's a matter of pride to us. In the end of the day, we shall get this right. We learn from our mistakes, and we have, of course, made them, but we shall get it right in the long run.
While police believe they're doing all they can, for many Asians, confidence in the police has been shaken by the events of 1978.
What the youths are experiencing is that if there is a meeting or demonstration of the Bengali people, say numbering 30 or 40 people, the police comes to know about that. But few weeks before, when about 200 National Front people marched and smashed everything in Brick Lane, and we just wonder how come the police didn't know about that.
I don't believe it for a moment the police did not know about it. It takes time to mobilize 200 people.
I believe the police knew what was going to happen on that Sunday, and if they wanted to, they could have stopped it. They could have stopped them coming to Brick Lane.
We want some action, firm action. If it's a question of self-defense, yes, we got to defend ourselves.
It may be necessary if the police are not prepared to enforce the law as it exists for the black people, to protect them as much as they protect anybody else.
That's the dilemma, yeah. I mean, we have been so long, we have been begging to the police, to the Home Secretary, to the Home Office and everybody, that stop it. We are insecure, we don't feel safe on the street or at home. And nothing has been done. And if the police can't stop it, we have to stop it ourselves, and that's it.
That has very serious implications, because it has serious implications about who enforces law, for who. And if black people are going to enforce their own laws for their own protection, I think that is a very, very serious situation. And I don't think it's something that we very lightly say yes to. But it may come to that.
The violence can never be one-sided. You see, that's the problem. Everybody's ignoring it. I mean, if somebody faces violence, the only way to stop it is counter-violence. And the existence of National Front, only, I mean, if it is not stopped, it will be a violent society. The British culture will be changed.
July 1978. East End Asians call attention to their situation with a one-day strike.
All the coloured community are on strike.
Because of racial attacks.
Brothers and sisters, today
is the first day when you are going to lead the first black strike in England.
The strike was a community strike. It was not an industrial action. It was organized by the black workers in Hackney and Tower Hamlet in order to protest against the racist attack and the racist killing. We felt that our message has been going through to the government and the police.
What you want to do is pick it here. Leave four o'clock in here. Too many of them, all right? The principle, we know what you're doing, so about five. So you pick your five and tell the others to move off, okay?
Let's get one!
You get one!
Let's get one!
You get one!
Nearly 3,000 people started the march from Brick Lane. Altogether, in Tower Hamlet alone, there were 6,000 to 8,000 Bengali people who did not go to work. A white youth started shouting at us. It was the racist abuse that, like, you cracky bastard. And police made no attempt to stop those people from throwing racist abuse, nor did they arrest them. And two or three Bengali young people, they got a bit uptight about it, but there was no sort of fight between them. But we were arrested. Our lads were arrested. And also a young white anti-racist were arrested. And we feel very unhappy about it. We feel the best course of action is to go and sit down in front of the police station in order to demonstrate our protest, and also to make the point that we will not leave until those three people are brought back by the police so that we can all march together. And they said, does not matter how long, if it is until tomorrow morning, we will stay. I should say that altogether we were sitting there nearly 2 hours, 1.5 to 2 hours. The sit-down was a successful event in the sense that we asked for those people to be brought back to us by the police, and that was done. The first time people realized that they can do things, they can organize themselves, had a tremendous amount of impact. Up until now, we have been seen as a kind of very weak group of people. But now we are coming up and we are trying to find our own confidence. And these are all very, very positive things.